Hello children, hope you all are fine and safe in your homes. Okay, so in today's class we are going to revise few previous topic which is quite difficult for you, and we'll just revise once because every week we are going with a new topic and new exercises, and it will be quite confusing, isn't it? So a brief revision, okay, not in detail, a brief revision just to know how much you can remember, you have already remembered. Okay, so children, before starting the class, what you have to do? Sit in a comfortable position, don't bend your back, make sure you have your textbook and notebook with you, and whatever you want for the video classes, and yeah, be away from all kinds of sounds and disturbances, and yeah, now 2 minutes of meditation. Okay, so sit straight, don't bend your back. Okay, close your eyes, breathe in, breathe out, breathe in, breathe out. Do this for 2 minutes. This improves your focus, isn't it? Yeah, now we'll start the class. So in today's class, I'm going to revise you the second term. Okay, after midterm, what the portions we have started, that portions which is quite difficult for you to understand, that I'm going to revise you. Like letter writing, we have discussed, that's a personal letter, isn't it? And one more, which is that making a sentence in a negative way, and another one, adverbs, isn't it? Yeah, that a brief explanation I'm going to give you. Okay, okay children, so first thing we are going to discuss is letter writing. So I have taught you in first standard, we have learnt leave letter, isn't it? Leave letter for principal. But in second standard, we have learnt a letter to a friend or a relative. So first letter we have learned for a friend. Okay, so that's usually we call as informal letter. Formal letter, what we write for offices, schools, or any government offices, whatever you want, banks or something. Okay, informal letter we write for our friends and relatives and family. Usually now technology has so grown up that we won't even prefer letters for our friends and family, but still you should know to write, isn't it? Yeah. So what we have discussed in a formal letter for a informal letter for a friend, a letter congratulating, you have to give a congratulations for friend, isn't it? That is a topic. This is the topic, children. We have to congratulate your friend. Okay, so first thing what you have to write, I hope you remember, first thing what you have to mention, address. Why do you need address, children? We need address to send the letter to your friend. If you write whole letter and you don't write address, where the postman will send the address? It's not possible. So address is very important. The first thing you have to write is address. So address includes what it has. Address will have door number or street, area, which area they stay, okay, or which colony, building name or something. Okay, depends on your address. Okay, place at the end, like Karnataka, India. Okay, states or countries. Okay, so address. So first thing what you have to mention, address. And in address, what and all should be there? Simple, I have taught you in two lines, isn't it? Okay, this all will include, I'm just telling you. So after address, what you have to write, leaving one line, you have to write date. So which date you are writing the letter. Okay, so after date, what you have to write? Dear friend. What you have to write? You have to start the letter now. Dear friend, you have to put a comma. Okay, this is the third step. The first step is address. What is the first step? Address. And then the next step is date. The next step is date. And the third step is you have to start a letter with dear friend. Okay, dear friend. So after this, you have to leave a line. Okay, after address, leave one line, write a date. Then after that, leave one line, write dear friend. And then again you have to leave one line and then write body of the letter. So what do you mean by body of the letter? Body of the letter is nothing but the content. Okay, what you are going to write. anything. So depends on the situation. Now you have to congratulate your friend. Maybe he has got a good marks in 10th or 12th. So based on that situation, you have to write it. Dear friend, it should be in your own words, children. Like, I'm very glad to know that you have got a very good marks and congratulations for your success. Isn't it? Like this. Okay, like birthday wishes if you want to do. Wish you a very happy birthday. May this year goes well to you. May you get great success. All these words we use, no? In WhatsApp and all, we used to type and send. Similarly, you have to write in this body of the letter. This depends on your own words, children. Okay? Since you are too small, so we'll teach you only what is there in your textbook. If you grow up and go to higher classes, you have to write by your own, the main body of the letter. Okay? So this is also important, but body of the letter is also important because that is the main thing what your friend is going to read. The friend won't read the address. Address, date, everything is for post your letter. Okay, this main body of the letter is for your friend. This is a personal message what you are sending, that I'm very happy that you got a good marks, may you get a great success in life, may you have a very good career. All these words will include in that. Are you getting body of the letter? And then after that, the last step is yours lovingly, or yours formal letter we use your obediently, yours faithfully. Okay, so similarly, you don't have to write it. Okay, yours is enough for you. Okay, yours, put your signature. You have to put your signature and write your name. Okay, yours, signature, name. This is the whole format of the letter writing to your friend. Are you getting? So first thing is address. Next is date. Then dear friend. Then body of the letter, what you have to write. 3 lines, 2 lines, 3 lines. Okay, depends on yourself. Okay, then yours, signature, and your name. But in if you remember, in first standard we have wrote a formal letter for your principal asking for a leave. So in that we have mentioned subject is main in that. Whatever you write in body of the letter won't matter. Subject is main. Subject they'll see, and depends on that they'll decide. But here no need of mentioning subject. Subject has been cancelled in this. Okay, subject is not there. Only you have to write your own words, like your to your friends and relatives. Okay, this is the format I have written. Now I will show you the letter in textbook. Okay children, so you can see here in your textbook, this is what the letter I taught you, isn't it? Okay, letter. A letter of congratulations to your friend. Yugan's friend Abhishek passed the annual examination with good marks. Yugan wrote the following letter of congratulations to him. Okay, so first thing what I told you is address. 3/8, this is a door number. Okay, Basin Enclave. This may be the area. Amritsar. Amritsar is a state. It comes in. So Amritsar is a city in Punjab. Okay, this is the place. Then after leaving one line, you have to write date, as I told you. June 17, 2020, or you can write. No, after one line, you have to write Dear Abhishek. So Yugant is writing to Abhishek. Are you understanding? Yugant is writing to Abhishek now. So Dear Abhishek. After that, leave one line, body of the letter. I am very glad to know that you have got very good marks in your annual exam. You must be very happy. My congratulations to you on your success. Isn't it simple, children? Did you understand that? Yugant is telling, I am very glad. Glad is nothing but happy. Glad to know that you have got very good marks. So I am very happy to know that you have got good marks in your annual exam. You must be very happy. My congratulations to you on your success. Then after leaving one line or two lines, you have to write yours, comma, Yugant's signature, and Yugant's name. Isn't it simple, children? Okay, I hope you got revised with this letter. Okay, we'll see the another topic. Okay, children, so this is another topic which we have discussed, making verbs negative. making verbs negative. That's nothing but they'll give a normal sentence. You have to frame it in a negative way. I am eating apple. I am not eating apple. Negative it has become, no? I am writing. I am not writing. Okay? She came to school. She didn't come to school. Okay? I'm going to revise you once. So children, sentences that has are, was, can, shall. If you want to, all these are verbs, isn't it? So to make it a negative, you have to add not, are not, was not, cannot, shall not. Okay. So if you want to get it in an example, okay, I'll give you the example. They are students. They are students. This is the normal sentence. They are student. If I want to make it a negative, I have to just add not. They are not students. Are you getting? Next. See. Jasbir was absent. This is a normal sentence. If you want to make it negative, was, you have to add not. N-O-T, not. Isn't it? I hope you remember it. It's very easy actually. Okay? He can swim. He can swim. He can swim. If I want to make it negative, not. Just add a not. N-O-T, not. Then, I shall come. I shall come. If you want to make it negative, just add N-O-T, not. Okay? This is one set of conversion we saw. Normal positive sentence converted to negative sentence. So similarly, there's one more part in this. Like, if a normal word like, no, if these words are there, and if I want to make it negative, I should add do not like, or do not know. I have to add do not, and then I have to add that word. Are you getting? See, I'll give you with an example first. Okay. They know the answer. Okay. They know the answer. So if I want to make it negative, I should not write they know not the answer. That is a wrong sentence. This is wrong. They know not the answer. That is wrong. So for everything, you can't add not to make it negative. Okay. So since these kind of words, you have to add do, N-O-T, not. Do not. They do not know the answer. Okay. They do not know the answer. Are you understanding, children? Such kind of words you have to add do not. Okay? Do not. Then similarly, words ending with yes. Like, for example, works. Okay? It is ending with yes, isn't it? Yes. So if I want to give an example, he works hard. So if I want to make it negative, I can't write he works not hard. It is wrong, isn't it? Sentence only is wrong. So what I have to write? If words ending with s, I should write does not. He does not. So works will become work. Only work. You should not add s. You have to remove the s and then you have to add does not. Are you understanding? He does not work hard. The words that end with s, you have to, while you convert it, you have to remove that s and write does not. Works प्लेस, कम्स, गोस, इज दीज आर वर्ड्स विच एंडिंग विद यस. आर यू गेटिंग चिल्ड्रेन? दीज आर दी वर्ड्स विच एंड विद यस. सो एंड देयर इज अ लास्ट पार्ट इन दिस. वॉट इज दैट? इफ द वर्ड इज पास्ट टेंस, इन पास्ट टेंस. आई डिड नॉट स्टार्ट स्टिल टेंसेज फॉर यू, बट स्टिल यू नो लाइक केम, गॉन, वेंट. ओके, पास्ट टेंस. एट, ईटन. ओके, सो ऑल दीज वर्ड्स वॉट आर देर, वॉट इज देर हियर. सो वॉट आई हैव टू एड फॉर दीज काइंड ऑफ वर्ड लाइक ही केम लेट. सो हियर केम इज द पास्ट टेंस ऑफ कम. आई विल टीच यू इन द कमिंग क्लासेस. केम इज द पास्ट टेंस. सो आई कांट राइट ही केम नॉट लेट. आई कांट एड नॉट हियर, इट विल बी रॉन्ग. वॉट आई हैव टू डू? ही डिड नॉट. ही डिड नॉट. केम विल बिकम कम. ही डिड नॉट कम लेट. See how it has been changed. Like previously, works has become work. Similarly, came is a past tense. I am writing present tense. Came has become come. He did not come late. Okay. I hope. Okay, little bit. If you understand, it's enough, children. Okay. So, in the coming classes, again, if I revise you a few topics, I'll tell you in detail about it. Okay, don't confuse yourself. If it is past tense, you have to add did, not. Okay, if the word is ending with s, you have to write does not. Then that word you have to write without using yes. And if the word like, no, all this, you for all these words, you have to add do. If the words are is, am, are, was, can, shall, should, might, all these words, you have to directly add not not beside that. You don't have to change anything. Okay? So usually you learn the simple sentences only. This is there in your syllabus, so I taught you. Okay? Okay. We'll see in a few in textbook. See children, this is what I taught you, isn't it? They are students. So this is a simple verb. Are has become are not. Jasbir was absent. Jasbir was not absent. I shall come. I shall not come. He can swim. He cannot swim. I am playing cricket. I am not playing cricket. We are watching TV. We are not watching TV. Isn't it? You can see here clearly, just adding not, the sentence has been converted. Nitya was laughing. Nitya was not laughing. So, till 6 examples, it is very simple. But after this, see here, 6-7 examples, they have given simple way. After these three cases are there. He works hard. So the word is ending with yes. Then you have to add does not. He does not work hard. They know the answer. They do not know the answer. For no, I have used do not. He came late. He did not come late. Came has become come here. Then we have solved a few exercises also. I hope you remember it. You have to practice, children, or else you will forget everything. Okay, this is what simple exercise we have solved. I hope you remember it. Okay. Okay, children, I hope you understood the topic and be practicing the letter and the what I have taught you, making verbs as negative. In the next video, we'll go with the new chapter and that's tenses. I'll revise you that in that coming chapter. Okay, thank you.